Good day, everyone. Today, we are going to talk about sexual health and hygiene. After this video discussion, you will be able to identify the important health habits for the developing adolescents and observe maintaining good hygiene. Let's start by defining the important terms. First is health. It is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. Second term is hygiene. It refers to behaviors that can improve cleanliness and lead to good health, such as frequent hand washing, face washing, and bathing with soap and water. Class, practicing personal hygiene etiquette is difficult, especially in many areas of the world due to lack of clean water and soap. Inappropriate washing of hands, face, and body can spread many diseases. Third term is sexual health. It refers to a state of physical, emotional, mental, and social being in relation to sexuality. It is not merely the absence of disease, dysfunction, or infirmity. Sexual health class requires a positive and respectful approach to sexuality and sexual relationships, as well as the possibility of having pleasurable and safe sexual experience free of coercion, discrimination, and violence. For sexual health to be attained and maintained, the sexual rights of all persons must be respected, protected, and fulfilled. And the fourth term is reproductive health. It refers to the state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity in all matters relating to the reproductive system and its functions and processes at all stages of life. It suggests that people with adequate reproductive health have a satisfying and safe sexual life, can have children, and can make a choice as to whether they would like to have children and when and how to have them. Now, let's start with a proper discussion. Puberty class causes all kinds of changes in the adolescent's body. These bodily changes are a normal part of developing into an adult. There are instances when these changes can be a source of anxiety to the growing teen. Does anyone not worry about smelly breath and underarms? Of course, everybody worries about it. This further outs personal hygiene and healthy habits being important life skills for the teen. Now let's start with oily hair. The hormones that create acne are the same ones that can make you feel like you're suddenly styling your hair with a comb dipped in motor oil. Each strand of hair has its own sebaceous oil gland, which keeps the hair shiny and waterproof. But during puberty, when the sebaceous glands produce extra oil, it can make your hair look shiny, oily, and greasy. Class, washing your hair every day or every other day can help control oily hair. Dozens of shampoos are available in drugstores and supermarkets for you to choose from. And most brands are pretty similar, although you might want to try one that's specially formulated for oily hair. Use warm water and a small amount of shampoo to work up. Do not scrub or rub too hard because this does not get rid of oil any better and it can actually irritate your scalp or damage your hair. After you have rinsed, you can follow up with a conditioner if you like. Again, one for oily hair might work best. When you are also styling your hair, pay close attention to the products you use. Some styling gels or lotions can add extra grease to your hair, which defeats the purpose of washing it in the first place. Look for formulas that say oil-free. Second class is we are going to talk about the sweat and body odor. Perspiration or sweat comes from the sweat glands that you always had. But thanks to puberty, these glands not only become more active than before, you might have this odor under your arms and your armpits. The best way to keep clean is to take a bath or shower every day using a mild soap and warm water. This will help wash away any bacteria that contribute to the smells. Wearing clean clothes, socks, and underwear each day also help you feel clean. If you sweat a lot, you might find that shirts, socks, and underwear made from cotton or any natural materials will also help absorb sweat more effectively. If you are concerned about the smell of your underarms, you can try using deodorant or deodorant with antiperspirant. Deodorants get rid of the odor of sweat by covering it up, and antiperspirants actually prevent or dry up perspiration. They come in sticks, roll-ons, gels, sprays, and creams, and are available at any drugstore or supermarket. All brands are similar, and one of that says they are making it for man or a woman is similar too, except for some perfumes that are added. If you use deodorant or antiperspirant, be sure to read the directions. Some work better if you use them at night, whereas others recommend that you put them on in the morning. But keep in mind that some teens do not need deodorants or antiperspirants. So why use them if you don't have to? Deodorant and antiperspirant commercials may try to convince you that you will have no friends or date if you do not use their product. But if you do not think you smell bad, you take daily baths or showers, and wear clean clothes, you may be fine without them. Our third topic is the body hair. Body hair class in new places is something you can count on. Again, they are normal and they are hormonal action. You may want to start shaving some places where body hair grows, but whether you do it or not is up to you. Some guys who grow facial hair like to let it develop into a mustache and beard. Some girls may decide to leave the hair on their legs and under their arms, as those things are all up to you and what you feel comfortable with. If you decide to shave, whether you are a guy or a girl, you have a few different choices. You can use traditional razor with a shaving cream or gel, or you can use electric razor. If you use a regular razor, make sure the blade is new and sharp to prevent cuts and nicks. Class, shaving cream and gel are often a better bet than that of the soap because they make it easier to pull the razor against your skin. Some of the newer razors in our local supermarkets contain shaving gel right in the blade area, making even beginners feel comfortable shaving. Some people also would try waxing or laser. Whether you're shaving your legs, armpits, or face, please go slowly. These are tricky areas in your body with lots of curves and angles, and it is easy to cut yourself if you move too fast. An adult or older sibling can be a big help when you are learning to shave. Do not be afraid to ask for tips. You might want to avoid shaving your pubic hair because when it grows back, the skin may be irritated and itchy. Now, let's proceed to healthcare check for the female. So, ladies, listen very carefully. The best time for a self-breast exam is about a week after the last day of your menstruation period, when your breasts are not tender and swollen. This would be done at the same time each month when you no longer have your menstrual period. Now, how to keep the external female genitalia clean? There are steps to follow. First, use soap and water to wash the external genitalia and your underarms every day, especially during menstruation. Use either a disposable pad made of cotton, which is a nylon base, or a clean piece of cotton cloth to absorb blood during menstruation. Third, Properly dispose the pad after each use, or wash and dry the piece of cloth used as a menstrual pad before use. Fourth, wash only the external genitalia. Do not try to clean the inside part of the vagina. Fifth, while washing, wash starting from the vagina towards the anus. Do not wash from the anus towards the vagina. This will allow germs to enter the inner genitalia easily and, class, it can cause infection. And lastly, if you see any changes in the vaginal fluid, a change in color or odor, please visit a health professional. Now, let's proceed to healthcare check for the male. So boys, please listen. First, wash the external genitalia at least daily with soap and water as you wash the rest of the body. Second, boys who are not circumcised need to pull back the foreskin and gently wash underneath it with clean water. Third, be aware of any abnormal fluids coming from your penis. Do not confuse this with the presence of normal fluids. And lastly, if you see any abnormal fluid or wound, please visit a health professional. In addition, class, since we are talking about hygiene, I would also like to remind you about our health protocols to remember. First, always wash your hands. Second, use a face mask, especially if you are going out in the public. Third, observe social distancing. Fourth, sanitize your hands and your goods. Class, by following these, you can help keep yourself, your family, and your community safe from the virus. I hope you learned something from this session. Thank you everybody for listening and have a great day. Bye!